Welcome to Home Oniship, your one-stop DIY shop. I'm going to show you how to make beautiful butcher block countertops while I bring this wet bar back to life. If you're redoing your hardwood floors or wood furniture, stay tuned. This video can show you how to do that as well. This project is rated O for Unify. And what does that mean? Working smarter and not harder. Let's go to work. Now, getting these wood boards together is typically done by gluing and clamping them, which can be messy and unpredictable, harder. Today, we're gonna unify them by using a pocket jig and wood screws, smarter. The inside, it makes a little pinhole to the other piece of the wood. Join your boards two at a time. Then combine your boards using the same method. A bit of advice. When you're using a jigsaw, you want to make what's called a pilot hole. If you try to plunge directly into wood with the jigsaw, it's going to be like you're stuck in a dubstep concert. Now and then I take your calls, I'm making promises. I'm making promises. I can't get enough of your love. Fill in any gaps or imperfections with wood filler. This is the part of the project that will have everyone at the home improvement store knowing exactly who you are. Saying, hey, how's the kids? Because you'll be back and forth and back and forth and back to the store because you're getting the wrong items. People have the misconception that you have to have a really high-powered sander in order to do a good sanding job. And while that may be half of the equation, it's half of the equation. Without the right sandpaper, the job will not be very good. The smaller the number, the coarser the grit, the higher the number, the finer the grit. Grits 40 through 60 are your stripper grits. You use these to strip off any finish. Paint, old stain, polyurethane, stripper grit is where it's at. It will get it off very quickly and effectively, better than any chemical stripper you could buy. If you have a chemical stripper at home, big spender, get the receipt and take it back. This is all that you're gonna need. Look at how coarse they are. Take a close look. Touch it. I'm kidding. To 100 grit sandpaper is for evening. It comes after the stripper grit to even out all of the scratches and uneven surfaces that it created. Once you're satisfied that your wood is even and level, you want to move up to your 200 grits. They've done a good job by getting cute with it and putting it in a sponge format because it is somewhat of a cleaner grit, meaning that you use it to clean the surface, make it very smooth, remove any splintering, and sometimes you get that gritty feel to it. You take your smoother grit and you smooth it right on out, and it just feels like silk when you're done with it. When you're done sanding, it's very important to clean the wood thoroughly. You want to take a tack cloth and wipe it off and maybe even vacuum it, but never ever put water on it. Polyurethaning your wood is a critical step. Think of polyurethane as a clear coat for your wood. It protects it from expansion and contraction and from scratches and damage. There's two types of polyurethanes, water-based and oil-based. The only two that I will recommend using. Oil-based. Once you apply oil-based, you can slide a chair across the floor and it will glide like it's on ice. But you will pay in labor. Oil base stinks to high heaven. It takes 3 to 6 days to dry and another 5 days for that smell to dissipate from your home.
Water-based polyurethane.
It dries in about an hour. It's virtually odorless and it's food safe. I'll give you one guess as to which one I like using. Here's a very critical mistake that a lot of people make. If you shake polyurethane, you introduce bubbles into it, and those bubbles will show up in your finish. Bubbles are your worst enemy when you're using polyurethane. You want to make sure that your stain is 1000% dry before you apply your polyurethane, because if you don't, the moisture from the wood will try to escape through your polyurethane, and that will result in white spots everywhere, cracking finish. That comes from not allowing your finish to dry completely before.
I had did a project once, and
I'm Oniship, I get her done. I walk in, white spots everywhere, in multiple rooms. I'm like, what happened in here? A cat got in the window and rolled around in the wet polyurethane. I called the manufacturer, like, you gave me a bad batch of polyurethane. But you know what the cause was? Impatience. Let it dry, just wait. If this happens to you, take 5 seconds and freak out, like this. Just take a long blink, like this. Then strategize and conquer. You get out your sander, you sand out the cracking or the white spots, and you reapply your finish, reapply the polyurethane. That's it. Smooth it out with a 220 grit. You know what to do. What? I'm a Pisces, that's how we freak out. Freak out like this.
Like no other.
Flawless. Absolutely flawless.
Perfection.
Flawless. Absolutely flawless.
Outlets? No problem.